Hi there. In this video, we're going to be showing you how to construct the incenter of a triangle. We're working on the fx-CG500 Casio graphing calculator, which is our CAS model. And you'll see it's a pretty big calculator. This is what the handheld looks like. If your students have it, they have a stylus they can use, or they can use their finger. It is a touch screen, so that's why the screen is so nice and large here for a handheld. I'm on the emulator, so I can use my mouse and I can toggle between the menu options. So we're going to go into the menu geometry. So I'm going to click it and it opens up my screen for geometry. You'll notice that my tools are up here across the top. I can open new pages, save things, edit. Here's the things I can do in geometry. So it's a full-on geometry software, dynamic geometry software. And so we're just going to look at a couple different things. So first we want to construct a triangle, and we want it to be a general triangle where you don't have specific properties like a right triangle, because we want the conjecture about incenters to be true for all triangles, not just right triangles. So the idea of making a generic triangle means you can then make it into other special triangles, but for the most part it's generic. So I can do that a couple ways. I can get the segment tool and make it out of three segments. I could go up to draw and use the special triangle tool, which is what I'm going to do because this is very fast. If I hit this, notice that this tool, so I could have also gone here and just used the visual cues. So this is a generic triangle. Once I have that tool selected, if I just select anywhere on the screen, it makes a generic triangle. And I know it's generic. I can drag these vertices anywhere and it can be made into any triangle. So I'm going to select a vertex B. Notice it kind of gets highlighted. Hold my mouse down or my stylus, if I'm using that, or my finger, and move it this way. You can make the points bigger. If you go into edit, remember edit's where, typical edit where you can change the way things look. So if I went to style, I could make that point much bigger than it is. Right now it's thin, so if I made it normal, it would end up being a little bit bigger, so you can see the difference. So for students, it might be nice to make them larger because they are easier to grab with your stylus or your finger. So here's my general triangle. I can, again, move any vertex and make it be a different triangle very quickly. So I could make it into a right triangle or into an isosceles. If I measured the sides, I could, you know, do that. So that's the point. It's any triangle. Now I want to do the incenter. And the incenter is formed from the angle bisectors. So you can, depending on what you're doing, we're trying to get right into the incenter and explore its properties. So we're just going to use our tools in the dynamic environment here. But you could, if you were trying to reinforce constructions with students, you could actually use the compass and a straight edge, and they could use it, maybe the real ones, and you could do the constructions that way. But we're going to use the tools. So I'm going to select an angle, and to do that, I select the two sides. I'm going to go up to draw, and I want to construct. And I want, notice these are all the things I can construct, but we're going for the angle bisector. And so there is the angle bisector, and you could verify it by measuring these two angles and make sure that they're congruent. And so now let's go and do the rest of them. So it's much faster because basically I'm trying to get right into that incenter. So I want to continue to do that. So notice up here, when I selected it the first time, it used this tool. It's the visual of a bisector. So now I can just use that for the rest of them. So select the sides, they're highlighted, and click the tool and it'll make the bisector. So now I have the angle bisectors of each angle in my triangle, and now I can explore. And what I'm going to do is show you an advantage of using the emulator software, which is what I'm using. So this is nice if you're teaching remote, distance learning, or doing a demonstration up in front of the class. You can actually make the screen now much larger. So the students have the handheld, but you can make your screen on the emulator much larger, and I'm going to show you how to do that. Simply right-click, hit resizable mode, and it makes the screen really big. And again, it's resizable because you can make it fit whatever screen you're working on. So I'm going to make mine pretty big here. Notice that my triangle that I had is now off the screen. And so the quickest way to get that back is to go to view and zoom it to fit, and you'll see your triangle is back. But now that it's larger, I can explore a lot easier and actually start writing some things down. So here's the exploration, and you'd have them drag and stuff. So one thing that they are going to hopefully notice is that no matter what triangle you make, even if you try to make it into a, let's say, a right triangle. And I might want to measure instead of just eyeballing. But let's say I make it into a right triangle, that this in-center point is still inside this, the triangle. So maybe one thing they've noticed is that the in-center, and maybe we want to actually construct that in-center. So let's construct the intersection right there. And there's this point. And here's where I might definitely want to go into my edit and style and make this a much larger, let's make it a big point so that it stands out so I can actually see it. So there's my inner center now. It's nice and large for me. So you're gonna have them explore, and let's say you're ready for them to start writing down their conjectures. So this is a nice feature of the CG500, is you can actually write text in here. So if I go up to my draw menu, text is an option and it makes a little text box. So we might write down that the in-center is always inside. No matter what kind of triangle I have, and as they've explored and moved things around, that seems to stay true, so they've written down a conjecture. So you could have students writing down what they're doing on paper, in the calculator, however you're gonna do it, but this is one thing I've noticed. So then you might want to have them measuring things. And so measure the angles. Is there something special about the angles? Is there something special about the distance between this in center to the vertices? Is there any special connection? Is there something special about the distance of the in center to, say, the side of the triangle, right? So let's see. So in center, side of the triangle, and we could go and measure that distance and see if there's some kind of connection. So here is my distance. So let's try it to the next one. So the distance, and remember, this is our horizontal distance. Vertical distance. Sorry about that. And so we're going to measure it again. And wow, isn't that interesting? The distances seem to be the same. So I'm going to make a conjecture that this third side is going to have the same distance. And so now maybe I have found something else about the in-center that is special about the in-center. And that's how I know I have the in-center, is if I measure the distance from the center, that point, to the side, I get the same distance for all three sides. So here's how to construct and then how to explore with the dynamic geometry capabilities of this tool.